If you see, Mandip Dosh has been there for quite a some time and people are following blindly. According to Vedic astrology, that the placement of Mars in the first house, fourth house, seventh house, eighth house, or the 12th house, it causes a Mandip Dosh. Now, this Mandip Dosh has nothing to do with the present analysis of one's horoscope. It mainly depends when the person is going for matrimony or for marriage purpose. During that time, it is seen that if Mandip Dosh is there, then there will be different problems which will be coming in the person's life due to the effects of the planet Mars, which will be causing a death. It can cause death, it can cause miseries, it can cause problems in children, and so on and so forth. But the actual cause of Mandip Dosh is still not yet known. People are just analyzing it and calling it just blindly, but according to me, it has to be seen more on a wider scenario rather than just following it in a proposed manner which is given in the Vedic text. Now, for matrimony purposes, was the placement of Mars in the first house. For this, it is seen that Mars in the first house causes problems to health, because this is the self. The horoscope is seen for self and the lagna chart is seen for the self. And for the fourth house, it is seen that fourth house being the house of happiness and house of family, it is also not seen well. Similarly, for the seventh house, it is the house of marriage, and placement of Mars in seventh house causes problems and marital discords. In eighth house, it is seen for longevity, and in 12th house, it is seen for hospitalizations and other losses. But if you see that depending on the one planet Mars, if we reject a good proposal, then it is not logical. So for a good proposal, what we need to see is 6 points which are very much required and to be seen in the male as well as in the female's horoscope both. It is not only on one horoscope that it should be analyzed. For matrimony purposes, I would say that first house is not so much important, whereas the second house is far more important. Second house in the horoscope is good, then it is seen that the family of the person will be good. Alright, and if you see, now coming to the cancellations of Mandip Dosha, there are several cancellations of Mandip Dosha. First of all, they say if the planet Mars is placed in the same house in the other horoscope or in the 1, 4, 7, 8, 12 houses, there is cancellation of Mandip Dosha. This is a very basic cancellation. Second, it is seen if Saturn or Rahu are placed in these respective houses, that is 4, 7, 8, and 12, then there is cancellations. Like if you see in this horoscope, Rahu is placed in the first house. So by the placement of Rahu, if there is a Mandip Dosha in the female horoscope or the male horoscope, the Rahu cancels the Mandip Dosha. Now, there are other cancellations in the Vedic text. Like if it is in its own sign, Mars in its own sign, there is cancellation. Then Mars in debilitated sign, there is a cancellation. Mars in exaltation sign, there is cancellation. Mars in enemy sign, there is again a cancellation. So, if there is Mandip Dosha, there is cancellation of Mandip Dosha also. We should not fear Mandip Dosha, and we should in fact try to analyze the real effects of Mars. Not depending only on its placement, but it's also combinations and aspects which are there on the various houses of the horoscope. As I was talking about the system of matching of two horoscopes, normally if you see Gundalan and Mandip Dosha are only two factors which are seen, and they are dependent on only on two planets, that is Moon and Mars. Now, if you are going for a matrimony, I would say that you should look at the person's horoscope in such a way that it's, first of all, what we have to see is that the person should have a long life. The age should not be short, and there should not be an accidental death or a death, untimely death, or what we call. Second of all, we want to see is that the mental tendencies of the person should be good. The person should have a free mind kind of a thing. Then the person should be a lively person, should not have depressing situations in his life or his life. Then third is the factor, that is childbirth. This is very important to be seen, especially from the female horoscope, because everybody wants to have a family in future, right? So to increase their name and to increase their family, they have a child. Suppose if there are problems in the female horoscope regarding childbirth, then there will be difficulties in having a child. And the fourth point is the health. Nobody wants a bad health. So it is always better to see if the horoscopes are having good health in future period also, and they should live a healthy life. Then the fifth point which I see normally is the separative tendencies. The separative tendencies are basically a person's attraction towards a marital life. Does he want to continue a marital life? Does he really is into a family? Is he basically a family person or not? And how concerned he is about his family? And furthermore, is there any combinations of divorce in the horoscope? Suppose if there is a combination for divorce, then the match is not recommended. And the sixth point which I normally see is the finances part, since everything is dependent on money right now. Whatever you want, whatever the things are there, it all comes down to what kind of a money you are having. So if there are increase in finances, because every married life or a family, every year, every time, there is an increase in expenditure. So to cover up that, there should be an increase in finances both in the male and the female horoscope. It is mainly towards the male side, because normally it is followed that the male is the earning member of the family. And if his horoscope is good for financial situations, then it is good. So summing up that, there are 6 points which have to be analyzed. Not only Mars and Moon, the rest of the planets have to be seen. Now coming back to the Manglik Dosh, there are a number of cancellations also.